This game between Cantú and Besiktas. Brian, how are you today?
Fine. How are you?
Yeah, I'm good, thanks. Are you looking forward to this game?
Yes, it will be quite interesting today. After Besiktas had a great win yesterday and Cantú had a very big lose against Elxleben, Thuringia Bolt. So, what do you think about this game?
Cantú have previously advanced to the Final Four, so I suppose on paper they are the favourites. But again, Besiktas with a big win against Albacete yesterday. Cantú lost to a very good Bulls team. To be honest, it's really hard to call. I mean, if you're basing it just off this Champions League, then Besiktas are the favourites. And they picked up a solid win against Albacete. So,
I think one key fact will be the first quarter.
Yeah, yeah,
who will
definitely
score easily, or yeah, who will score?
Yeah.
And then we will see how the game goes on. So
yeah,
that will be quite interesting. So already we got the starting five from Cantú and Besiktas. We will start with Cantú. The number 4, Papi. Number 5, Jininazi. Number 13, Perez. Number 14, Badoon. And 22, Carrossini. For Besiktas, we got number 1, Khan. Number 7, Yilmaz. Number 10, Cem. 12, with Güler. And number 35, with Gümüş. Sorry for that. Again here, we're very sorry if we didn't pronounce the names right.
Yeah.
Our Turkish and Italian is not that good.
Yeah.
At all.
Out of all the leagues here, I'd say I know the least about the Turkish league. I'm presuming that's the same with you, Brian.
Yeah. So that's why maybe sometimes we mix up the surname and the first name. So, but I think for the shouldn't be any problem.
Okay. Just at all. 2 minutes to go till step off. Cantú known for very tough and aggressive defense, so we will see how Besiktas will combat that.
Yeah, also Besiktas played a very good defense yesterday, physical defense, and it's quite interesting how Cantú maybe will proceed with an aggressive defensive compared to the Thuringia Bulls yesterday with the quick plays, quick movements even in the defensive. 1 minute to go.
And as we saw yesterday, key threats for Besiktas is Cem Gajinski, who gets into the key and uses his massive height to make an impact. Other key scorers is Yilmaz and Gümüş.
All the 2 and 3 pointers that scored quite well yesterday.
Yeah.
During all the game. So that's also helping Cem during the game, because otherwise the team just can, the Cantú could just focus on Cem.
Yeah.
But they've got no chance to do that.
No.
Otherwise, yep, the mid-pointers will kill them.
Yeah. Besiktas have a very strong line of 2.5 3-pointers.
It's nearly the whole Turkish national team playing for Besiktas right now. I think it's just Gubalak missing and maybe one or two other guys.
Yeah.
So that's quality on the pitch for Besiktas.
Yeah. Ten seconds to go till tip.
The referee's still collecting all the balls laying around the court. Good spiel. I think today's referees are from Germany with Eric Etzelmüller, a Spanish guy named Samuel, yeah, and then Finnish with me, and from Serbia, Milutin Jelinek. So quite experienced referees. I think yesterday the coach from Cantú complained that some chair defense skills from the Bulls were a foul, and the referees didn't give them as a foul.
Yeah.
What do you think the referees could impact on the game?
I mean, I don't know too well how the refs differ from Italy to Germany, but yeah, Cantu certainly said that some of the, you know, their strong defense were being called as fouls when they were just trying to play aggressive defense. So we will see if that applies in this game, where they apply strong defense, and we will see whether it gets called as fouls or not. And now teams are just getting ready to tip.
Honestly, I think they all referees made a good job yesterday, as they try that the players decide the game and not the referee, like in some other competitions. Oh, Champs won the tip-off.
Besiktas get the ball. Kahn with the ball. Over to Yilmaz. Back
and
to Kahn.
At least some Besiktas fans were in the gym today.
And Karasino with the rebound to...
From Carosini, pass. Carosini takes a mid shot and scores.
Yeah, Carosino with the first bucket of the game. Yilmaz with the ball for Turkey. To Gumas.
Nice play.
Good defense by Cantu. Chairman side. Unable to capitalize. Fast break by Cantu.
Badoon
on the fast break. Well defended by Cantu. By Besiktas. And Badoon from Argentina.
Whoa, nice pass.
Nice pass inside.
What a nice movement from Badoon.
Yeah, lovely ball movement by Cantu there. And it was...
Number four, Papi scored it.
Yeah. Papi with the score. No, yeah, it was.
And Jasmine is doing a good roll there. Nice pick.
Unable to get the drop. Rebound by Badoon.
Foul. Oh, okay.
And Badoon keeps control. Fakes the three. Pass to Genesi.
And now he takes... No.
Back to Badoon.
Yilmaz.
Nice defense by Yilmaz. And Genesi knocks it down.
Right now, better start for Cantu. First 3 minutes.
Kahn with the ball at top to Yilmaz. Knocks
nice
it down from the baseline.
Von Yilmaz. And the coach from Besiktas tells him, hey, keep calm and keep focused.
Badoon to Genesi again.
Oh.
And Genesi from inside with a nice pass by Papi. Great ball movement by Cantu in the opening minutes.
I think technical issue, broken push rim.
And Perez. Getting a tire change. Perez also from Argentina.
Chem on the 3-point line with the ball, passes now to Kahn. And Kahn probably go for the three-shotter.
Kahn for three. Knocks it down. Nothing but net for Kahn.
Genonozzi keeps...
And Carasino
Gula
to Badoon. And Badoon tries to fake the three. Good defense by Besiktas.
Nice steal from Gula.
Yeah, nice steal there. Gumas with the ball. To Khan. Khan to Gumas. To Yilmaz.
And again,
back over to Khan.
Two with Chem. Long ball to
Chem again. And to beat the buzzer, and he does.
Chem was close.
Jasinski there. Nice inside bucket. Just in the nick of time. And Genesi brings the ball up for Cantu, over to Berdoun.
Berdoun
from the baseline doesn't go. 45 degree doesn't go. Jasinski. Inside to Gumas.
And oh, too long.
Unlucky long basket there. Nice pass by Bajek Castle. Oh, and
unsportsmanlike
foul. Berdoun goes flying. Foul is called on Yilmaz.
Unsportsmanlike
foul.
That was a stupid foul, yeah. Because he had really no chance to reach the ball, Berdoun.
Yeah.
And he just waited to get the contact.
To be honest, quite a dangerous foul as well. Berdoun could have seriously hurt himself.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. Just saw it in the replay that he just hit the back wheel.
And Berdoun just readjusts his chair before taking the free throws. Cantu will get the ball back after this. Score is
8-7 for Cantu.
Yeah. Cantu is listed as the home team in this game. Bajiktas is the guest.
Misses the first one.
And Berdoun knocks down the second. Now giving Cantu a 2-point lead, 9-7.
And with the opportunity to make another 2 or 3 points, as he keeps the possession after the unsportsmanlike foul. That was quite
Gumas
early
with
shot.
The rebound. Yeah, quite a forceful shot there by Cantu. Khan, nice chair skills. Just drifts us in and out the Cantu players, Yilmaz.
He almost fakes the shot and from Papi.
And the foul is called on
Papi.
Number 4, Papi, yep. Bajiktas sideline ball. Khan.
Fakes the shot, passes to Cem. Chem takes his wide shot.
Pulls up and nothing there for Chem. Berdoun will inbound for Cantu. To Genesi.
Genesi keeps Jasmine out. Chem in the middle position.
Caracino over to Papi and off the glass. Easy shot for Papi.
Now Papi is taken out of the game.
Yeah, pressed out by Chem. Jugensi. I'm just going to call him Chem from now on. Apologies to any Turkish fans.
Nice shot.
And Yilmaz there with a nice shot. Timeout called by Cantu.
The coach didn't look happy from Cantu after these 2 points.
Cantu still have the lead, 11-7.
It should be 11-9, I think. Maybe in a couple of minutes we'll get 2 points. So. So. Actual score right now is 11-9, so it's quite a good defense from both teams today.
Yeah, definitely.
Cantú is keeping Cem good away from the key.
Yeah.
So he has to take very hard shots right now.
But it's smart for Cantú to do that because as we saw yesterday, Bajiktas just destroyed Albacete with the inside shot, especially from Cem. He's just so dangerous from that range.
Yep.
Also, Badoon fakes the shot. No, he takes
it. Badoon for three. Nothing there.
Way too long. Again, it's way too early to take such a shot. They still had 18 seconds left for proper ball movement.
I agree.
Like Bajiktas now.
Yep.
A free throw. And Cem.
Guma.
Oh, misses it.
And Cem again. Nice control by Cem to control the ball and the finish. Yeah, I as you said earlier, Brian, I couldn't agree with you more. Way too early to be shooting threes.
Yeah.
So much time on the clock and great ball movement by Bajiktas.
Wait. Oh, Perez with the offensive rebound. Yep. Now she's in trouble.
Nice pass.
Cem is for the defense right now out.
And Bardoon fakes it. And again, Bardoon shooting those big shots early.
Again, offensive rebound. Nice pass.
And Papi knocks it down from the baseline. Yilmaz with the ball for Bajiktas to Khan to Gumas, and play is stopped as Caracino falls out of his chair while he's in the key. Nice mutual respect between these two teams, as you see, whenever the opposition falls out of the chair, Bajiktas offers a handshake.
Yeah.
Nice sportsmanship.
Technical issue for Cem. I think he's got gets a flat tire. And new in the game is Toprak. He came for Yilmaz. Yeah, he came in for Yilmaz. No. Oh, for number 35, Ferret. Cem with the inbound. Well, today the ball handling from Cantú is way better than yesterday. Oh, Papi with the foul on Cem.
Yeah, Cem will go to the line to shoot two. Foul is called on Papi.
Nothing
there for Cem on
that
the first.
That was a quite impressive air ball from Cem.
Very rare miss.
Or did he want to hit Sebastian Magenheim on the banner?
Cem unable to convert. Slightly frustrated there.
Denossi with the inbound. Khan tried to take Papi out.
Badoon with the ball for Cantú.
Again, Badoon is the guy who keeps the ball a little bit too long.
Knocked away by Cem. And it is now Ugar on the fast break,
ball
stolen by Cantú. That's Badoon with the steal. Over to Denizi. Fakes his three.
And Badoon will take it. No.
Badoon also fakes his three. Nice to Genesi. And he misses there.
Top.
And Ugar with the ball for Bajiktas. over to Khan. Khan unable to convert.
Papi makes it fast, and now it's a 3-2. No, everything settled up.
And Bardoon over to Carasino, to Genesi,
easy
to knocks it down from the top of the key.
From 1 minute to go in the first quarter, 15-11 for Cantú. That's long.
Papi with the rebound to Genesi.
3-on-3, and Cem is coming for help in the middle.
Papi shoots over Cem.
Timeout for Beşiktaş.
A timeout is called by Beşiktaş. We have 28 seconds to go in the first quarter.
So both coaches are not looking quite happy right now. So will be quite interesting to see how the team can now react for the last 28 seconds and also in the second quarter.
Gumas inbounds to Ugar and they let the ball roll so the game clock doesn't start. Ugar at the top over to Khan who weaves inside. And
foul number 22, Carosini, and that will give Beşiktaş another 12 seconds in the offensive, the last 12 seconds. Ooh, whiskey
and
pass.
Nice drive by Ugar. Ugar got into Gumas.
Nice
check by Bardoon. And Bardoon to Papi.
Papi with
Papi from half court. Nothing there. And at the end of the first quarter, it is Cantú with 17 and Beşiktaş with 11.
So we will see quite intensive game, and this game will definitely be won through the defensive movements, not
definitely
through the offensive, like yesterday. Also, the spectators from Cantú and the two guys from Beşiktaş trying to give the best.
Yeah, the Beşiktaş and Cantú fans are known to be quite rowdy.
So Cantú will start the second quarter in a couple of seconds. Maybe with normally they should extend the lead now a little bit. two substitutions for Cantú. Number 7, Ahmed Raurani is on the court, okay. And number 10, Zanturelli. Beşiktaş stays like they finished.
And we have some first quarter stats. Cantú are 8 from 15 from the field. With Papi on 4 from 5 and Genesi on 3 from 4. And Beşiktaş are 5 from 14 from the field. Yilmaz 2 from 4. Cem 2 from 5. So yeah, as you said, Brian, this is going to be a very defensive game.
Yep.
And Ugar with the ball. Over to Khan for 3.
With an open.
Nothing there.
Two out. Cem is waiting in the middle.
Nice ball movement by Cantú. Caracino from the top. Nothing but net.
Quite interesting that Badung is keeping the ball quite long in his hand. Even he puts it on his knees and waits what happens.
And Jasinski.
Cem misses the easy shot.
And Badung.
Now.
To Caracino, nothing there.
Offensive rebound from number 10, and he scores then. From Zanturelli.
Yeah, Zanturelli with a nice inside shot. Gets the offensive rebound and makes the points count.
Ugo under heavy pressure on the 3-point line. Khan passes back to Ugo, to Cem. He's got a mismatch already. 24 second violation.
Yeah, Khan did get the shot off there, but the basket will not count.
Jasmine out and Khan out for Beşiktaş. Subs in number 76, Tuche. And
Tuche, yeah.
Number 11, Yumuk Chafa.
Genesi, over to Badun.
Nice movement there in the defensive from Cem and Tunçay.
Yeah, really jumping out on the shooter there.
Long ball and
good defense by Beşiktaş.
Steal.
And 2K to Cem.
Cem makes it, tries to make it a little bit fast. Nice
steal there by number 11. For Beşiktaş, that is Yumuk. And Tunke was fouled, he will.
Zanturelli didn't watch what the referees are showing.
It was not a shooting foul, so there'll be no free throws. Beşiktaş inbounds. And Tunke on under the paint, gets
and
the shot
scores.
To drop. Badun to Genesi. Oh, and Eldris off the front of Badun's chair. Good hustle by Badun to keep it in.
Oh,
and
no,
fourth shot by Genesi. Again, good defense by Beşiktaş and good ball control by Badun.
So that was the second time out now for Cantú in this half. So as we can see on the stats in the first 5 minutes, we just had 9 points from Cantú and 7 from Beşiktaş. So So there you can see it's a really aggressive defense play right now. And it keeps all the time. As we now just got 21-13, so that's just 4 points for Cantú and 2 points for Besiktas in 4 minutes. So that's really good defensive play today.
Yeah, from both teams. We are about to resume play. 6, just under 7 minutes to go in the second quarter.
Both teams stayed like they went off the court for the timeout. Then very aggressive from Genoazi on Ugo. Ugo still under trouble. 8 seconds left. Ooh, nice shot from Ugo.
Yeah, lovely shot there. With one arm.
Besiktas is trying something like a half-court press.
Yeah, it seems to be very effective, making, forcing Cantú out to take big shots. Foul is called on 11.
You always need to be aware if you defend a player without any legs, because they're quite tippy and turnable in the front if they get a hit. So there you need to do a clever movement to these players. Nice steal.
Yeah, Chen with the ball over to Kunke.
Chen is in the key.
Kunke to
Ugar. Ferwich.
Nice pressure on the shot there.
Ball.
Genizi. Burns to Aruri.
Santorelli with the ball now. Cem is now pressuring him.
And Bardoon to Genizi, to Santorelli. Nothing now.
Right now, in the key, Besiktas got really big problems to score right now. The easy points, Cem is leaving out, Ferret is leaving out. And that's quite unusual for Cem.
Yeah. And in substitutions for Besiktas, in comes Denzies and Yilmaz back into the game. And that was Dimagi with a shot for Cantú.
Ten seconds left.
Chen with the ball. Pressured by
3 seconds violation. Just looking to my left and wondering, did you see Ian Sager already?
No, Ian Sager, I believe, has not entered the game as of yet, which is...
He's not even on the bench right now, so that's quite unusual right now. Just wondering.
I have no idea.
Oh.
Oh, here he comes now. I have no idea why he's only entering the bench area now. They must have had I don't know. But obviously, if he is playing this game,
maybe we'll find out later.
You'd expect him to come on, make a big impact.
Yeah. Performance 30 still to go.
Caracino brings up the ball for Cantu. Caracino, part of the Italian national team.
Badun keeps the ball, makes some fakes. Cem is helping out.
And Demagi off the glass from mid-range. Santarelli tries to get the rebound. Projecta still control the ball. Cem over to Yilmaz. Yilmaz from the elbow. Nothing but net. Demagi again from long range that time.
Cem with the ball. Brings the ball from coast to coast till now, and there's
Cem with tries to drive in.
Offensive foul from
and hard defense by Cantu. So an offensive foul called on Cem now.
Cem is getting the break after I think a second personal foul.
And Caracino.
No, personal, first personal foul for Cem. Fijiktas is now in this quarter already on team fouls, so every next foul is a free throw. Santuelli misses the layup.
Yilmaz will bring up the ball.
Tunçay looked unhappy right now because Yilmaz didn't play the ball.
A foul is called on
Khan,
and Brzyktas are now in team fouls. Aruri will go to the line.
Two shots for number 7 from Cantu.
Again, apologies if we butcher the pronunciation of some names.
First was not good. Second free throw is not good, and still ball for Cantu, as Khan couldn't catch the ball.
But doing well inbound.
Long ball
to Demagi. But doing to Caracino from the top.
Again, back off to the wing.
Ugar. He can't. Ooh.
That was a nasty movement from Badu.
Yilmaz from the elbow. And he makes it.
6-point lead for Cantú right now.
And as you notice, Yilmaz, who's a key top, makes a big impact for Beşiktaş. Likes his shot from the elbow. Being consistent from there in this game.
Nice ball movement from Cantú.
Yeah, nice inside shot for for Santorelli with the assist from Caracino. Yilmaz, nice pass inside to Tunke, and he scores off the glass. Great ball movement by both teams. Would you agree, Brian?
Yeah. Both teams play very aggressive, again, defense. They are always near the chairs. They're always stopping the ball if they can do it, and helping each other in the defense.
And nice inside shot by Arori, and
also you can see that nearly every attack is taking nearly always 24 seconds.
Yeah.
Offensive foul.
And would you agree with me on this, Brian? Is that Beşiktaş are focusing a lot on Cantu's big guys.
Yeah.
And therefore allowing the small guys to just infiltrate the key. Would you agree?
Yeah, definitely. So they still got 13.4 seconds left in the second quarter. So maybe that will be a 3-point shot from Khan. And Tunçay makes it nearly as a buzzer beater.
And yeah, Caracino there with a buzzer beater. Demanding for an and-one there, and was frustrated that he didn't get it.
Yeah, we will hear just before the third quarter back. We will tune off for now, and we're back in 50 minutes.
Yep, thank you for joining us, and stay tuned. Thanks.
Will be quite interesting. What will be your thoughts about statistics from the first half, Dylan?
Yeah, I mean, close game, as you mentioned. A lot more of the focus has been on defense rather than offense. I mean, personally, I'd like to see a few more shots dropping, but I think from a team's perspective, they're looking to just keep that defense tight and try and secure the win here. It could go either way at this point. What are your thoughts, Brian?
Yeah, a little bit more scoring would be nice.
Yeah.
I think a little bit we are still fresh from yesterday's late game Thuringia Bulls against Cantú, with 61 points in the first half from Thuringia Bulls.
Yeah, yeah.
Now we're getting a good defense shown, and Cantú still playing with the same five as the Leaf left for the half. Also Beşiktaş, so still no game time for Ian Sager, for example.
Yeah. And then Beşiktaş have brought in Can Delay. Delay, very experienced player. Of course, he's on the Turkish national team as well. Yilmaz to Gumas. To Ugot.
Nice pick and roll there.
Yeah, lovely pick and roll.
Nice
and
help from Bedu.
Toucan swings it back out to Yilmaz. Yilmaz knocked off balance.
Demachi to
Demagi to Aruri.
And Yilmaz with
Santarelli unable to get the ball. Cantú perhaps should have taken the time on the offense. What do you think, Brian?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think that Bedu needs to pass the ball a little bit faster. He keeps it a little bit too long and drives a little
and
bit
Demagi
too much with the ball.
With a shot from the top. Puts Cantú ahead by
six.
Six, yep.
Now they can play Yilmaz. 5-4. Yilmaz under pressure, Bedu is waiting in the middle.
Yeah, Yilmaz pressured by Caracino.
He
swings it to Toucan.
Hard, complicated shot for Toucan.
Jump ball is called and Cantú will get the possession. Demagi will inbound to Bedu.
Bedu long ball to Ahmed. Nice pass there.
Caracino over to Bedu. Bedu, nice inside to Caracino. And the bucket counts. Interestingly, Caracino does not get the and one. I'm a bit confused with that, Brian. Would you say he deserved the and one there?
No. He kicked himself out. He just leaned a little bit way to the back and then fell out of the chair. There's a weight missing in the front to pressure with his feet. Oh, nice steal.
And a steal by Aruri.
Bedu helps him.
Bedu. Oh. And Caracino trails and gets the bucket.
Timeout from Beşiktaş already.
Cantú ahead now by 8. No, by 10.
After just 1:50, timeout for Beşiktaş. Yeah. The coach is not happy.
Yeah, Cantú really making the most of the fast break points. And, you know, that just shows you how quickly a direction of a game can change in such a short space of time.
Yes. No. Looks like Beşiktaş is not that focused. In the beginning of this quarter, and Cantú is making the best out of it. The defensive is aggressive on the chairs, stopping the chairs. They've got the fingers in the passing ways, so it's hard for Beşiktaş right now. And if Beşiktaş will lose that, then it depends on the Abakete game later on. And then tomorrow will be a show-off match between Cantú and Albacete at 10:30, I think. Well, quite early tomorrow. Oh, 10 o'clock.
Yeah, 10 o'clock. So it is an early game.
So, Beşiktaş ball after the score from the timeout.
Yilmaz swings over to Gumas. Back to Yilmaz. Inside to
Uğur.
Nice pick and roll by Yilmaz and Uğur. Bedun for three, knocks it down.
I think that's his first or second. He just hit from
yeah,
the three
yeah,
point line.
Yeah, second three-pointer, I think. He hit one in the first half. No. And Yilmaz fakes the three.
No, it's
pressured by Caracino and he loses the ball. It
was his first three-pointer. So right now he's on the three-point line with 33%.
And a Rudy pressured by
Ugar. Violation.
And Besiktas will get the ball. Nice defensive pressure by Besiktas. Delight to Yilmaz from the elbow. To Kate.
Kate. Nice block there from Castronelli.
And Demagi gets the ball to Caracino.
Maybe it's the time for Besiktas to take us up. Maybe.
And Batun again for three. And again. Two from two. In this quarter from the 3-point line. Batun.
Maybe some.
It's a lights out shooter.
Oh, yeah.
When he wants to be. And Ugar replies.
No,
nothing there.
No, no. Khan and Chem will return onto a court.
Cantu forged ahead 41-27 in the third quarter.
Oh, Chem injured during the game his hand, as we can see right now. So he's been taped there on the left hand. Maybe that could explain why he missed so many shots.
Yeah, definitely. And then Demagi. To Caracino, pressured by Tunke.
Because 28%, that's not the Chem I know.
Yep. Tunke with the ball for Besiktas. Over to Chem. And obviously it was his non-dominant hand that got injured. Yeah. So he's still able to post up effectively, as we just seen. Still dangerous. Even when he's injured. Batun again. Nothing there. Bit of a rush shot there. Gumas to Khan.
I just watched Chem's feet a little bit. He's always quite close that he will touch with his feet the ground, and it's always quite close. So there you need to be aware of right now in Germany, because more and more referees are keeping the focus on these players.
Yeah. And Cantu now on the fast break. Batun, finger roll, nice finish. The ball came off Caracino, so it will be Besiktas ball. Nice aggressive pressure by Caracino.
9 seconds left on the shot clock. Chem in the bench. Short pass to
Gumas.
3 seconds. Nice
to beat
shot.
The buzzer. Nice finish from Gumas. Gumas, one of the best 3-point players in the world, plays for the Turkish national team. Caracino to Demagi from the top, nothing but nets. And Cantu really steamrolling ahead now. Just under 4 minutes to go in the third quarter, sorry.
Oh, Ferret couldn't catch the ball from Khan. There's a mismatch.
And Demagi with a rebound.
Nice no-look pass there from Badoon.
Yeah, not nice finish by Santarelli. Khan over to Gumas.
Again, not that good pass from Khan. I think it's now the third or fourth pass.
Amazing pressure from Caracino. And Khan fades from the top. Nothing there. And it will be Cantú ball. Subs coming in now for Brzyktis is number seven Yilmaz replacing number 76.
Tunche.
Caracino having a really good individual performance both offensively and defensively.
Bedroom's watching the shot clock.
Yilmaz.
Chased by Badu and makes foul.
The basket will not count.
The foul was way earlier than he shot.
And the foul is called on 14 Badu. Chem will inbound.
So it's 16 point lead now for Cantú. Cem needs to take the shot. DiMaggi with a nice shot.
DiMaggi just inside the 3-point line. And Brzyktis really struggling to find their offensive stride here in this quarter.
There was just the foul committed to Cantú, number 10. Can't find him. Santarelli. Otherwise, Cem would be in the bench and could be easy points for him.
Khan for three. Nothing there.
Santarelli again with the defensive rebound.
Bertoon fakes it. And Caracino
fakes a short pass.
Nice pass inside to Santarelli. And
Gumas with
the rebound. To Khan. Khan looking to drive. Pass across into Cem. Cem from inside. And again, even with one arm, so dangerous as ever. Cem really keeping Brzyktis
30 seconds in left it with in this quarter. So that will keep 13 seconds for Brzyktis if they get the rebound.
And DiMaggi for three.
It's too long. Yilmaz with the ball and we got 12 seconds left. Cem is inside with the foul.
And one for Cem.
Foul was committed to number 22, Carosini.
Cem will go to the line to shoot two, to shoot the extra point, complete the 3-point play.
Four seconds left. So maybe Cem could try to hit it on front of the wing and get it back to himself. Or he will go for the basket.
And Cem knocks it down.
4 seconds.
Caracino will inbound DiMaggi to Bardoon. And miscommunication there on the pass. That will end the third quarter. Cantú 49, Brzyktis 36. Brian, what are your thoughts on this third quarter?
Good start from Cantú. They Beşiktaş were sleeping at the beginning, and Cantú saw the opinion to take a lead, and they grabbed it instead of sleeping as well. They were in the defense on the chairs, stopped Beşiktaş, and they had really tough problems with the 24-second violation. And also Cantú still got one player or two player did not play, so they got still fresh players on the court, on the bench. So what's your thoughts?
I mean, the complexity of this game really changed within the first minute, wouldn't you agree, when Cantú just really capitalized on the fast breaks in the first few minutes, and then ever since then Cantú have really been unstoppable offensively. And you know, with Beşiktaş, the only one that's really scored in loads was Cem.
And
from inside the paint, so.
Quite interesting, Cantú even increased their shooting percentage by 3%, and Beşiktaş dropped it by 3%. So, Beşiktaş were in the first 5 minutes, they just made 4 points. So that's way too much, too less. On the opposite side, Cantú made in the first 5 minutes of the quarter 12 points. So that's the reason there's a big gap.
Yeah. So just running through the stats. Cantú are currently 23 from 42 from the field, 54%. We've got Papi 4 from 5, Genesi 3 from 4, Rauri 1 from 2, Santarelli 3 from 5, and Berdun for 2 pointers, 3
Khan
from 11,
nice movement
and
there
3 pointers,
to Cem.
2 from 5.
And Cem scores already.
And I'll go through the rest of the stats later, we'll get back to the action. And Demagi brings the ball up for Cantú to Berdun.
Also Berdun's telling which setting
Caracino
they want to play.
To Demagi. Caracino inside to Aruri. Unable Cem to get the basket.
With
Cem
the
with a rebound.
Two players from Cantú are out. Passes to Cem. Short. 12 seconds left.
So substitutions now coming in for
Papi.
Cantú.
It's we'll
number four
again.
Papi and number five Genesi. Yilmaz shoots over Genesi. Papi pulls up
and scores again.
Knocks
he's
it down.
Still from the 2 point, he's still 100%. Papi. So
yeah,
it's now 5 on 5 Yeah, 5 on 5. So that's good shooting from him. Cem.
Yilmaz tries to get it to Cem. And the ball will stay with Beşiktaş. Khan. Gumas back to Khan inside, unable to convert.
Berdun with the ball, passes to Papi. There's a foul offside, not being committed.
And Yilmaz helped back up by the team staff.
Puppy with some nice movements and the first miss from Puppy. The seven pushed the hand from the defensive player away and was a foul committed to him. And now Cem and Ferrit are trying to take him out for this. Now Ferrit is with the player. Cem inside. Khan needs to... Okay.
The ball will stay with Bajiktas.
7 seconds on the shot clock. Ferrit, Khan, Yilmaz is whistling. 3 seconds,
Cem.
Post up.
Unable
no
to get
score.
The drop. Cem. Papi with the rebound.
Oh, misunderstanding between Papi and Genosi. Timeout Cantú. So now you can proceed with your stats for the viewers.
So the stats for Bajiktas, they are 17 from 39 from the field, 43%. Khan, 1 from 5. Yilmaz, 4 from 7. Toprak, 2 from 3. Cem 5 from 11 and Gumas 1 from 6. And 3 pointers. Khan is 1 from 3. What are your thoughts on this quarter so far, Brian?
It's quite interesting. Bajiktas is trying but can't reach Cantú. It looks like the Bajiktas is holding the players are holding the ball too long and not seeing the three persons inside of the court and not playing as a team like they played yesterday against Albacete. So they need to find some ideas now. With 7 minutes left, maybe to go for team fouls and send Cantú always on the free throw line. And also, they're always quite easy handling errors from Bajiktas right now. Like we just had Yilmaz, and number 7 from Cantú nearly pinched the ball. Again, handling over from Yilmaz. Couldn't control his chair.
And now Aruri brings up the ball for Cantú. To Genesi.
Got all the time in the world now. Well, 24 seconds they've got.
And Santarelli and one for Santarelli. Nice drive low inside the paint for the easy shot. Somewhat of an unnecessary foul, don't you think, Brian?
Like now, from Yilmaz. Air ball from Santarelli. 7 is on the ground. Santarelli is now back and the coach is telling they should play a box and Ahmed is trying to go back and Papi with the foul. Third,
Yilmaz with the ball. Tugumas doesn't convert. A lot of Bajiktas' shot haven't converted in this second half. What are your thoughts on that, Brian?
Not only in the second half, also in the first half. Easy shots were not converted. And from my point of view, Yilmaz is holding the ball way too long. He always gets problems when the big guy comes out. And then he makes a bad pass to Khan, and that got intercepted 3 or 4 times right now. And also he sees the big man.
And Gumas, nice inside shot off the with the assist from the Yilmaz. Pape to Arudi.
That's wrong. Cem is now gain some speed. But Badun, nice defense against Chan. Forced him away from the key. So Cem couldn't make his way into. Now he's in, and Yilmaz
to Gumas. Nice ball control by Gumas, and the foul is called. Gumas will go to the line for two.
And Ferris, normally if he concentrate on his shot, then he normally should score it instead of moaning about the phone, then shoot, take the shot. So the attitude right now from Zita is not on the right level from my point of view.
Okay.
They're more complaining, not playing as a team. They're not focused for my...
Yeah.
It looked like they're not focused.
It certainly seems like a very different Besiktas to what we saw yesterday, where they systematically, with all due respect to Albacete, took them apart yesterday, so... Berdun. To Papi, nice inside pass to Santarelli. And again,
scores.
Santarelli so crucial with the nice inside bucket. You know, Santarelli really demonstrates how essential the low pointers are for easy inside buckets.
Yes, because so then... it's...
Foul is called on Santarelli.
I think Santarelli right now is with 10 points or something, so he's quite important right now.
Either 8 or 10 points.
So we're just having a quick look to the Switzerland. Right now where the Titans are playing against Cologne. And Cologne is leading just before the second quarter finished by 5 points. So it's 19 Titans, 24 Cologne. If Cologne wins this game, they're the first in this Europe League One. So it's quite important for Cologne, who is in the German league right now on the last place. So that's a standing on the other court.
Yeah, and then if Cologne win that game, they will go to the EuroLeague One finals in Sheffield the end of April. And now back to Champions League action.
Again, they're not watching the shot clock.
24-second violation.
Silly, stupid handling errors, which normally... on this level should not happen as often as we can see that now.
Brian, would you just mind searching up the Champions League Group A result?
Yeah.
So the
no, that at 17:13, Landil is playing against Bilbao.
Ah, okay.
So they're
the game hasn't started
no,
yet.
No, they start just in four before we start our second
okay.
game tonight.
Yeah.
So
should be a big game for Landil and Bilbao, both really good teams. And now back to the action here in Elxleben. Yilmaz with the ball.
Cem is again in. And again, Yilmaz is not passing the ball to Cem. It's, I think, right now the fourth, fifth time this quarter already where Cem is inside and he's not getting the ball from Yilmaz. Badun is hassling the ball. Always focus on the ball there. Papillon again. 3 seconds. Steal.
Badun with the ball for Cantú.
Cem with the ball. Elkay is inside. Cem now inside with Yilmaz in the ball. Yilmaz passes. Bad pass. Cem is moaning to the referee. Two minutes, 13 to go, 17-point lead for Cantú.
Right. Nice ball movement. Although also good defense by
Projectors.
And Cem.
Cem is watching the big shot clock. The game clock.
To Ugar. Back to Yilmaz. And Cem posts up, and again from that trademark spot for Cem.
So 1 minute 42 to go.
And this links back to what you were saying earlier, Brian. That, you know, perhaps if Cem got the ball more when he was in the key earlier on, Projectas would have extended. It would have been a lot more of a closer game.
Yes. Also, if you just count the 3 or 4 handling errors from Yilmaz, where he didn't pass to Cem.
And Badun to Papi, who knocks it down.
So Beşiktaş just got 2 things what they can do. Try start to score with 3-pointers, which is quite hard with Badun. It's doing a very good defense. And to start to foul. Send Cantú on the line. But right now Beşiktaş has got no team fouls. So they've just got 1 foul committed. So the opportunity for Beşiktaş.
And Ugar goes to the line after the foul from Badun. Slightly frustrated with himself for picking up the foul. And Ugar makes the second.
The two Beşiktaş fans making a good show here in the gym. Badun's taking time from the game clock.
Smart move by Cantú.
Badun takes the shot now.
And he knocks it off the glass.
Two shots for Beşiktaş.
Foul is called on, I believe, Aruri.
Number 10 was committed, Santorelli.
Oh yeah, but yeah, by Santarelli. My mistake.
It's his fourth foul already.
Just over 30 seconds to go in this game.
Cem misses first free throw. And the second. So
yeah. But very, very uncharacteristic from Cem.
Yeah. I think he finished the game already. I think he's just watching the scoreboard, that the gap is not too big and they need to win the last game against Thuringia to be in the next round for sure. Pass to Papi. Papi scores.
Yeah.
And Cem is not happy. Nice, 3 seconds to go.
Nice bank shot there from Papi.
Oh, that's a big win for Cantú today.
Yeah, that is the end of the game. Cantú beat Beşiktaş 65-45, big 20-point win. I'm sure Cantú are very happy with that. Following the loss yesterday against the Bulls, they've regrouped well against Beşiktaş. And on the other side, Beşiktaş, a big win yesterday, but a loss today. I assume frustrated with the loss. What are your final thoughts on the game?
Good defense from both teams. Mm-hmm. Cantú's defense was a little bit more aggressive.
Yeah.
That was what Beşiktaş played yesterday, an aggressive defense against Avaketa. That was missed today. So there will be a nice game tomorrow morning at 10 o'clock. And I will say now goodbye. And we hear us, I think, 5 minutes before the game starts, we're on the live coverage again.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay.
Before we go, we'll just give you the game, the game statistics.
So we've got the top scorer with Papi for Cantú. And then we've got several players with Santorelli 10 points and Carosini with 10 points. No, Di Maggi, sorry for that. And we've got with 11 and we've got with 11 points Berdun. So the referees are just shaking off with our hands. And on the other side, we just got two players with more than 10 points. We've got Cem.
With 15,
and we've got number Bülent with 10. All other players are way below.
Yilmaz with 10.
Yilmaz, sorry. So that's big disappointing for Beşiktaş.
Yeah. Cantú shooting 56% with and Beşiktaş with 43%. Yeah.
So.
Yeah. Anyway, I've been Dylan Cummings alongside Brian Roberts. Thank you for joining us. Be sure to stay tuned in for German commentary for the Bulls versus Albacete game later tonight. That will be brought to you by
Martin Schenk.
Martin Schenk, the editor of Rock Magazine, and Brian.
Yes.
As well. So once again, thank you for joining us. I will be back tomorrow morning at 10 a.m. German time to bring you the Cantú versus Albacete game, along with Brian.
Yes.
Thank you for joining us.
Thanks for listening to us.
Yep, and we will see you later on. Cheers, guys. Thanks.
Bye.
Bye.